Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. My name is Keisha. I love to talk about planning and journals, and I'm so excited to bring you this unboxing because this is my very first Erin Condren EC Squad participation. I was approved to be an EC Squad member a couple of months ago, and I really love their program because it is like low, I don't want to say like low maintenance, but they let you really do kind of like whatever you want with them. There's not so many like strings attached, and they reached out to me and they offered to send me these products for review to help them announce that they are going to be selling academic planners at Barnes and Nobles now. So that's really, really exciting. And let's see what we got. Oh, this is so awesome. So this is an extra. They sent me the two planners that are now available at Barnes and Nobles. So you don't have to order these online. You can go to your local Barnes and Nobles and pick them up in store. I have never had an academic planner from them, but as you know, I have plenty of other planners from them. So I'm really excited to do like a flip through to see what is in here. And they also sent me colorful fineliner pens. That is really, really awesome. We'll test these out too. So I do have an affiliate link at the bottom of the description here. Go ahead, if you haven't checked out the website, go ahead, click that link and you can check out these planners there. And let's see what they look like. So these are the two planners that are going to be available at the at your local Barnes and Noble's location. They are online too. If you go to barnesandnoble.com, you can get them there. And they are the academic planners. And the academic planners are $45 MSRP for the Hello Kitty, which is, of course, my absolute favorite. You know I love Hello Kitty so much. And then it's $40 for the Star Wars edition. And these are made in USA. And they are a bit cheaper than their like standard planners, the Life Planner, just a little bit cheaper. So this might be a really economical option for you if you are looking to save a little bit of money. Let's get into the layout of things. So I can already tell. So there are two different kinds of layouts. This one is probably the focused layout, like a really, really minimal. So we'll walk through this one. And then this one looks like it's like their colorful version, their standard like Erin Condren line. So let's go through the minimal version first and save the best for last. But if you are a student, this is great for you. And I actually plan on using this for a course that I'm going to be creating and kind of like giving myself assignments as if I were in school with this. So this is the monthly, like month at a glance, perpetual calendar kind of almost. So it's really minimal. And you have your heritage and awareness observances on this page. You have a class schedule that you could write down over here. You have your times, days of the week, the course name, your teacher, location, credits, and notes. This would have been awesome for me to use in college. I don't even remember what I was using as a planner in college. I don't think I was using a planner in college. Can you believe that? That would be a totally different story if I were going back to school now. But so this looks like this. Begins in August, actually. So we have a July, like maybe summary, dates to remember in August. And then we have a monthly calendar, and you have your July calendar over here at the far left corner, and then your September calendar up here at the far right corner. And so I guess like that helps you see sort of 3 months at a time. Maybe if you need to like plan for exams or things like that. This is a really interesting layout. So you have an August goals, events section, and notes. You have projects and exams for the month with your deadlines. You know, you don't even have to really use this for school. Like, we have a lot of projects at work, so I could even just like pick a couple of projects that I want completed within that month and then write them here with a deadline. That would be really cool. And then here is sort of the meat of the planner, the layout. So you have your layout in like three different sections for the day, and then Saturday and Sunday are shortened because I guess they assume you don't have to go to school Saturday, Sunday, and then you just have a little to-do checklist right down there, and that is the layout for, you know, every single week. That's what that looks like. And then at the end of each month, you get a few note pages. Wow, that's kind of interesting. Oh my gosh. This is almost, you could almost use this like a hybrid monthly planner and like budget planner if you are someone who uses the monthly Erin Condren and always wanted like weeks in between, because you still have your sort of note pages in the back here that I see a lot of people using for like their monthly expenses, their weekly check-ins and things like that. This is a really cool layout. Oh my gosh. I think I'm gonna have a lot of fun like being creative in here. This is really, really, really kind of cool actually. It's nothing like I've ever seen before. But anyway, every month is pretty much the same. You get your monthly, your little summary, projects and exams, pages, your weekly, and then at the end of the month, you get those blank pages, which I think could be super, super useful. I'm even like thinking like you could use this for the verse of the day if you're into like, I don't know what to, like faith planning, I guess is what I would call it. Like right now I'm using my Erin Condren vertical to do the verse of the day. I'll show you what that looks like. I haven't put out this video yet of how I turned my Erin Condren into a disc bound, but just a quick sneak peek. This is how I've been sort of planning this week. This is a ring bound planner, except I chopped up my Erin Condren to fit a ring bound, took it out of the coil, and then so here is my week for June, doing my verse of the day, and then like just my little task list. So that's how I've been using that, and you could totally translate this kind of a system into here as well. I feel like there's definitely a lot more room to write in that sort of like capacity. So let's see what's at the back of the planner. And it starts in August because I think most schools start in August. So it goes from August to August. And that is it. So in the back, you don't get the pocket like you do in the Life Planner, and there aren't any stickers. So that is this version. This is like the focused version. It's very, very minimal. Now let's take a look at the Hello Kitty cover, which is more of their colorful line. Let's see. Ooh. Not enough room on my desk. But this is the Hello Kitty cover. And then this is the front page where you could stick your name. Oh, let's do some comparing. So this is the month at a glance. And if you remember, the month at a glance in this one has a little notes section at the bottom. You don't get that notes section at the bottom of this version, but you do get your heritage and awareness observations, observances calendar over here, your class schedule. And I'm kind of thinking, oh yeah, they do it by semester. So two semesters, is it two semesters? Yeah, two semesters in a year, right? I went to college and I was on quarterly system. Oh my gosh, that went by so fast. So yeah, this would be like the first semester, and then a second semester class schedule. And you get lined note paper there. And then, ooh, you get into August. So they don't have the mini calendars in this version up at the right and left. This looks just much more like the standard life planner kind of setup. You do get this goals and events summary page, and let's see what the difference is there. So these are round check boxes, I guess, and these are square check boxes. Projects and exam has a colorful header, and the font is the same but bolder and I think smaller, and this is a larger, like a larger size but not bold font. And then let's see, let's compare the weeklies. I feel like that is a like a larger font for the days of the week. Let's try to zoom in. Like, it's a larger font for the days of the week than in this version. And oh my, did they have the same start date? I just didn't flip to the right. Let's look at the, this one starts, oh, that's really interesting. Am I going crazy? Oh, I'm in September. Sorry. Okay, here we go. That's the same week compared side by side. So there you go. And then in the corner here, the colorful version has the month in color, and then this one obviously not, and it's in a different font. So that's neat. Something neat. And then it's the same throughout the whole month. And then you do also get these extra note pages in the back. That's really, really cool. I should look up how other people have used their academic planners. I only see Life Planner plan with me's, but this could be really cool too. So that's that. And then we'll just, I think these are like standard Erin Condren colors. So I will just walk you through them. And yeah, you let me know if you use the academic planner and if you've bought kits for them. I have a feeling. Let's take a look at some kit stickers. But I have a feeling they would pretty much fit any existing kit stickers that you might already have. Let's see if I can pull out some really quick. Guys, look what I found at Claire's the other day. I am so obsessed. I bought a Boterm cover from Amazon and it arrived and it was the wrong product, like altogether. But it's kind of a blessing in disguise because I found this one before that one arrived and I was like, oh no, what am I gonna do? Two planner covers, two new planner covers at the same time. But now I know that this one was meant to be, so I've been using my little machine A5 planner cover. But yeah, that's a little side note. I can't find my stickers. Let's see. Okay, here we go. So these are stickers that I made. I have an Etsy shop if you are interested in these patterns. But I want to see if like a standard monthly would fit in here. What do you want to use for July? I can't even use July, so I have to start in August. Let's do the B. Obviously, yeah, can't keep both of these, so I'm gonna keep the Hello Kitty one, but I am going to be giving away the Star Wars one to anyone who would like. So I will figure out a giveaway situation soon and announce that. It's gonna be in a huge, huge bundle. I'm approaching 1,000 subscribers, so anyway, that giveaway is coming up soon. And in the back here of the colored version, you do get some stickers. So you get stickers that say exam, midterm, test, quiz, read, paper due, study guide, study vacation, and no class. And yeah, and that's it. What a cool planner. I'm actually kind of impressed. So, I know when I saw these, I like wasn't sure how I felt about them because, one, I'm not in school anymore. And two, I didn't know how I would use the layout, but now that I have it in hand, it seems, I'm actually really excited about it. So yeah, this fits any of your sort of monthly layout stickers that you may already have in your stash. Let's just go ahead and decorate August while we're at it. Oops. This is super cool. I'm really excited about this. Okay. So the way that I planned out my stickers here is I put the month on here so that you could use them for, I don't know, whatever rolling month was around. And so I'm just going to stick my little August up at the top. We are going to find my handy dandy tweezers because we're going to do these date covers. And then this is the washi that I chose to match. And that'll just kind of go down here at the bottom. And then they did send me like extra pens, which is super, super nice. So thank you so much, Erin Condren team. I know that you don't pick everybody to send product to, and I just feel really honored to be chosen this month and given a chance. So thank you so much. This is actually really, really fun. Okay. So there we go. And now let's do our date covers. All right, and that is my monthly spread for August, already done 2 months in advance. So when I come in here, everything will be set up. And I just remembered I am enrolling my daughter into preschool. So this could be a really cool like way to keep track of like stuff that's going on for her. She's probably not gonna have homework or anything like that, but maybe there might be like, I don't know, special events to do or things like that that I might wanna keep separate from my other planners, but there we have it. Any of your standard monthly kits are gonna fit in there, and then of course you could always use your weekly kits in here too. I'm pretty sure like the horizontal versions of things that you might have would fit really well in here. And I'm like trying to see if I could decorate it with this weekly. I'm like, what I would do in here? I don't know. I might need to design some stickers for this because I think I would want to do some sort of like header over here. Let's see, do these fit? I feel like they're too long. Let me see what I'm doing. These are supposed to fit the vertical or the hourly, and I mean, you can center them and make them fit, but they're not like exact. But if that doesn't bother you, that could be like a nice little header up here. And you could do something like, there's already a to-do over here. So maybe how about remember? And then I want to pick like a little icon. Here's a clock. So remember, these are like time sensitive things to do on Monday. And actually I do have some time sensitive things to do on the first, like payroll, things like that. But anyway, that's beside the point. And then I'm really super excited for these blank pages here. Really want to utilize that for like budgeting. I think that would be really, really, really cool. Okay, so that is that. Let's check out these pens that they sent me. So this is the colorful fine liner pen set, and it comes in this really hard plastic case that I believe is like reusable. Let's see, what is this? I don't want to break anything, but I'm pretty sure you can like clip it back here. Oh, that's really interesting. Oh, it tells you how. So yeah, you click everything in the back here, and then like it becomes like a little stand. So, ooh, look how teeny tiny that is. The tip of this pen is so small. Let's try to get that in focus. How cute. So let's do a quick little pen test here. See how it works on the Erin Condren paper. This one is called Marigold. That is a really, really light yellow. I already lost the cap. Is it under here? There it is. And we'll just go through these really quick. Awesome, and those are all the colors that come in the pack. Here is a little like view of the color names and a little circle swatch, and then that's how they look on paper. It's very like true to the classic Erin Condren colors and their colorful line, and this is the pack that is called Colorful, so that totally makes sense, and it would go really, really well with this version of the academic planner, because I think pretty much all these colors match like all the tabs and all the months and things like that. So that is pretty cool. Anyway, and so that concludes the tutorial. If you haven't subscribed yet to my channel, please consider it. This guy will be in a huge massive giveaway if you are interested. And make sure you do subscribe so that you are notified when that announcement comes around, because I will be giving this one away and this little cutie. She's mine. Sorry if that was the one you wanted, but this is also a really awesome layout for anyone who is interested in using the planner. And that is it. Thanks so much for your support. I really appreciate you always coming by and sticking around with my channel. If you have any questions, let me know. Leave me a comment, and I will see you in the next video. Bye, friends.